I'm going to be reviewing four digital picture frames from $75 to $207. These make a really great gift because not only are they a physical gift, but you can add a personal touch by adding your own photos, and each of these frames makes that easy to do. I want to mention that this video is not sponsored. We were not given money by any of these brands, and we bought all of these ourselves, but I will be putting affiliate links in the description, so if you buy one, we'll get a couple dollars. All right, let's get into it. I'm going to start with the least expensive and also my least favorite, which is the Arafuna frame. If you're giving this as a gift, the box isn't that impressive. This is the box. It's brown. It's pretty generic. Frame itself, when I first opened it, my first impression was that it seemed a little bit cheap. It's really high gloss. There's a little bit of rippling when you look at it from an angle, as well as some very minor, small scratches on the frame. It's the smallest looking of the frames, even though they're all an 8x10 screen. And I think it's just also the least attractive overall. The good news is about this one, it's a pretty good deal because it's $75. It has the Frameo app that you link up. It's got a touch screen and you can add photos over Wi-Fi. The picture quality was also kind of shockingly good. It had good contrast, the colors were pretty accurate, but some of them had a little bit of a stretch, a little bit of a distortion. So if you're giving a gift to a photo nerd who really cares about picture quality and isn't going to care about the aesthetic so much, this would probably be a pretty good option. Next, we have the Marvue frame. This is $100, so for $25 more, you get this frame that seems much nicer. You also get this nicer box. It's more substantial. I think it looks like a more high quality gift. It has some matting, which is just, I think, more aesthetically pleasing. The setup to this was the most confusing because the setup involved using the same Frameo app as this one, but also you had to set it up on the screen. So you're kind of going between the two, but that's kind of a one-time thing. And once you got used to it, it was fine. Overall, the picture quality was not as good as the less expensive one. There's less contrast. The image itself looks lower quality. And so this one was surprising to me because I thought this would be one of the best frames, but the picture quality wasn't great. I would recommend this one to someone who cares more about maybe interior design, how the frame is going to look in their family room or wherever they have it, and someone who's not going to be nitpicking the picture quality as much. So if they're not a photo nerd, not a tech geek, but you want to share the pictures, this one's a pretty good option. The next one is the Nix Play frame. Let me get you the box. This has a really nice box. It was a good experience unboxing the product. It seemed high quality, nice packaging. The frame itself seems high quality, but I think that the design has the least mass appeal. It's a little more glam. It's a little more masculine. I could see this on a man's desk. The back has a design to it. But there's this gold edge that goes all around it, but it seems substantial. It doesn't seem cheap, even though it's plastic. This was an easy setup. It has a different app, but it was good. It has a touch screen. It was pretty simple to set up. The picture quality itself is just okay. It's better than the Marvue, but I think not as good as the Arafuna. I would recommend this to someone who's in between. A little bit tech nerd, but you know, a little more masculine and cares about what the frame looks like. So I imagine giving this to a dude and he'd put it on his desk at work or something. Another thing I want to mention is the transitions, which you've probably noticed. They remind me of like screensavers from the 90s or something. And this one is $207. This is the most expensive one. The next one, which is my number one favorite, is the Aura frame, and this is $180, so it is the next most expensive one. The packaging is beautiful. It's substantial, it seems like luxury, and it's just pretty and simple. It also was the only one that had this cool feature where you could use the QR code, and without opening the packaging, you could preload the frame with photos. So I think this is the most gift-worthy one because it looks high quality and it's easy to set up for your recipient. The frame is also really nice. It's plastic like all of them, but it's all streamlined and built in. It has a built-in stand in the back. The other ones kind of have clip-on stands. It's the only one that can't be wall-mounted, but if you consider the cord, that's kind of difficult to do anyway. And this has the best photo quality by a mile. It does not have a touchscreen. It has a little bar on the top. But I think what they saved on the touchscreen, they made up for in the picture quality. It actually looks like a high quality print behind glass. It's beautiful. The transitions are simple. The photos stay on the screen for longer, which is nice, I think. This is my absolute favorite. I'm going to be giving this one to my grandma for Christmas and loading it up with the pictures of her grandkids. Oh, this one also has its own app, which is high quality, easy to use. I liked it a lot. I think this is the most giftable option. I think anyone would like this frame, but I do think that each of these have their place. If you're thinking about giving any of these as a gift and preloading them with pictures of your family, I would recommend doing that now since things are taking a while to ship. I think all of these are a great option. Like I said, Aura is my favorite. I think my second favorite would be the NYX Play. Unless I was giving it to a person who cared about interior design, then I would go with Marvue. And if I was just giving to a tech nerd, photo nerd that didn't care as much about being aesthetically pleasing, I would give them the Arafuna. I think this is probably the best value, even though it's not as luxury of an experience. So that's all. If you're gonna get these, please use the links down below in the description. If you want more information about all things photography, how to take pictures, which gear to buy, please consider liking the video and subscribing to our channel. Thanks so much.